Talking to one of the best fighters on the planet, one of the nicest people, Keith One Time Thurman with a new haircut. No ponytail. Hey. Looking fresh, fly. Hey. So, first of all, what goes through your mind? Manny Pacquiao, Earl Spence. You know Earl. You actually fought Manny. Mm-hmm. What do you think?
I mean, it's a great matchup. I mean, this matchup is only happening because I fell short of victory. You know, but Manny still wants to be in the ring. We've heard, maybe not a lot of us have heard, but I've heard little rumors. This may be his last performance in the ring. We were already saying that his number of age was getting up there when he performed against me back in 2019. Yet he was very impressive. He did some veteran moves. He took care of his defense. I definitely don't think his work rate was the most, but he picked his moments. He got that knockdown. He was able to piggyback off that extra point, and he was able to squeeze out the W. So, you know, can he do that again to another real big welterweight who is a southpaw this time? When was the last time we saw Manny in the ring with a southpaw?
I'm trying to think. It was a long time ago. It's been a while.
A long time ago. It just changes the dynamics. I think a lot of things that Pacquiao does that's very awkward for right-handed fighters might not end up being as awkward for Spence. Yet, it still might be awkward for Spence. We have yet to see it, and that's why we're all excited to see this fight.
Keith, many times I ask people who fought Manny or sparred him, how many hands did he have when you were fighting him? Brandon Rios told me 8 hands. Sparring mm-hmm. partner told me 6. Did it feel like you were fighting an octopus in there? Like, did the punches come from everywhere or not?
No, he did do the classic double punch. Now, the double punch is not this. The double punch is like a drummer, and they go, and it's right here, blah, 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 blah. So what Manny does is he attacks, he hits you with a hook and an uppercut as if it was almost one punch, you know? And that makes you feel like you're getting hit. You're getting hit from two different
spots
in one moment, because the split second that he goes from this punch to that punch, it's so rapid. But luckily, I actually know that technique myself. Inside, I smiled after the knockdown in the fight, but sometimes when he was trying to sneak the uppercut in like that, I was smiling inside because that was a signature move that's really Manny Pacquiao. Now, back in the day, he did have 8 arms because he would do the boom-boom, but then he had and he would throw those 6-punch, 8-punch combos that made us love Manny Pacquiao. Let's be honest. It's those 6-punch and those 8-punch combos. He did it to Oscar De La Hoya. He did it to Brandon Rios. He did it to Timothy Bradley. He did it to so many fighters. But when he fought me, he was more of a two. I felt only 2 punches. I felt 2 arms. They just were very fast. And he's just a dynamic fighter. He's very experienced. He's a true veteran. He feels comfortable in the ring. He loves a good fight. You give him a fight, that fire goes in him, and he can't wait to return it.